Welcome to my studio in the Highlands of Scotland, from where we share with you this Elphen tutorial, showing how to paint Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. In the first book of the Elphen Chronicles, the story was all about Lacewing and her swarm. And one of the illustrations for that book was about the three Elphen warriors, Bloodsword, Serpentspear and Thunderaxe. And each of those had different coloured wings, and the light was glistening from the cells of those wings. And one of the most common questions I received from people who saw the painting or bought the book was, how did I create that transparency? Well, over the years I've painted many elfin wings, and they come in many different shapes and sizes and different colours, and quite often the way the light falls on them is different from painting to painting. But there are certain things which are common, and that if you start to understand how transparency and reflection works on the surface of one of those elfin wings, you too would be able to paint those elfin wings in any circumstance or in any sort of light. So in this particular study of Webstrand, which I hope that you will paint along with me, you will find that I've used as many of those different qualities as possible. In this box set of Elphen Tutorials, I share with you the painting process that will enable you to work along with me in not only capturing Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer, but also her precious tooth gathering pouches. I also show you how to depict her wings when fully opened, and her elegant hands on which she wears her swarm leader's eye ring. And finally, the forgettledust and remembledust shakers, which protect the elfin magic. And keep your eyes open for the glass mouse. My second book, in which I chronicle a most significant event in the life of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer, tells of her meeting with the earthling Fizz and their journey to Shemistra. Welcome to Watch and Wander through Paul Taggart's Elphen Chronicles and this bonus feature, for which I revealed some insights into my Masterworks oil painting, which portrays the swarm leader Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer, whose critical mission on one particular occasion is influenced by her meeting with the earthling Fizz, as recounted in my second book in Paul Taggart's Elphen Chronicles. Watch how the painting goes through many stages as I share the initial sketches and watercolour paintings before moving on to this Masterworks oil painting, followed by a stage-by-stage reveal. I would love to introduce you to my oil painting portrait of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. Webstrand is first seen in Fizz's bedroom. Fizz is the earthling child who has just lost a tooth, and Webstrand, for her own reasons, has come along to collect it. She is seen for the first time in the moonlight at the bottom of Fizz's bed, and I wanted to capture the moment when she leaps up onto the bottom of Fizz's bed. She really wanted to have a chat with Fizz and not just collect the tooth. It's important, of course, for the rest of the story. Capturing that moment in oil paint was something which I really wanted to do, because it was a challenge in lots and lots of ways. It was moonlight, it was dark, The moonlight coming through the window had to be captured, and so did all of the glowing gems on Webstrand's costume. So let me take you for a walk around the painting so that I can really explain a little bit more about Webstrand herself, about her costume, and also the way that I actually captured that in oil paint. Let me first of all take you to the window at the top of the painting. This is the source of moonlight. You could imagine that if this was painted very strongly, being such a geometric shape, it would really attract the eye. And it took a long time to soften that down. As you watch the reveal, you will see that softening process taking place. It's drawn in quite powerfully to begin with, and then gradually it moves back and back until really it's only a suggestion of light in the background. Beneath it is the dark of the bedroom itself, essential to show the gems of the costume against. In painting, the way to create light is by contrast, and so the background needed to be really dark. But at the same time, that dark area covers quite a large area. So you will see that on the left-hand side, directly below the window, that darkness is actually a dark blue. As we move across the painting to the right of Webstrand, it becomes a much warmer colour. And then going down the painting on that right-hand side, it turns to a green. The green is the reflected light of the duvet beneath it, changing those dark colours or those dark coloured greys into colours themselves, creates an interesting background, although we keep the value dark all the way through. The same could be said for the bedpost. The bedpost, which is important a little bit later on the story, when Webstrand stands on it. But again, that is very subdued. Although it's an incredibly interesting area with full of reflections, it had to be kept really soft. You can imagine if this was really, really strong, it would take the eye away from Webstrand herself. When we go on to Webstrand herself, we move on to an area of really strong focus. And so I'm going to take you bit by bit through her. We're going to start right at the top of the figure with the headdress and move down so I can explain both what all of those, the elements of her costume are and how they were all painted. Her costume is comprised of two main sorts of gems. The headdress itself and her earrings are created from light gems. And you can see that they have a slightly cool radiance. They are found on Shemistra, which is the Elfin's home planet. And there are literally fields or vast swathes of these light gems to be found there. Below those, around her neck, we have a different sort of gem altogether. These are the star gems. And the star gems come from a separate place altogether on Shemistra. And their acquisition is a very important part of the story. And it's all linked up to the human teeth. However, you can see all of these gems glow. They all emit light of some sort. The glowing is created in oil paint by tinting. Tints are semi-transparent or semi-opaque glazes of colour, which are softly laid over the gems or the light sources once they're dried. So this painting could not be created, as it were, in one go. It had to be created in layers. And once again, if you check on the reveal and look at these particular areas, you'll see them first painted in, then softened, and then slowly begin to glow. So the light will slowly build on those areas as you watch them in the reveal. One gem that I haven't mentioned up to now is the gem that she has on her left hand. And you'll see that is glowing too. That is a star gem too, known as an Elphen eye gem. And its main purpose, or its two main purposes, are first of all to summon the swarm. Webstrand is a swarm leader, and as such, she's in charge of her own, if you like, little legion of Elphen who help her in her tasks. She summons them by rubbing that eye gem. It is also used to open the starway. And the starway is a corridor between Earth and Shemistra, used by the Elphen to move back and forth between the two planets. The light gems continue down her bodice and move right down to the tooth pouches, which hang from her waist, in which to collect her teeth and carry them. These are actually seed pods which have been reused for the purpose. And they too, as you can see, are covered in light gems. Across the pouches, they follow a line along which those pouches open. They open in a way like an oyster. You can imagine an oyster opening and a pearl being in its center. And that's exactly what happens with the pouches. They take the teeth almost like pearls in their center and then close again so the Elphen can forget them until she gets back to her home planet. The skirt, which hangs from Webstrand's waist, is made of spider silk. You can see that it doesn't just hang, it clings. In fact, this spider web moves on its own accord. It continually tries to wrap itself around the legs of the Elphen. But on the lower part of her legs, you can see it moving and starting to curl. It has a life of its own. Moving on to the Elphen wings. All Elphen wings are coloured differently. Webstrand's wings are generally blue. Here, the moonlight is falling through them. And as it falls through all those different cells of her wings, it has a prismatic effect. The light is broken and shattered, giving an opalescent quality. So that in some parts of the wings, the blueness of the wing comes through. In other parts, it seems to warm up and become slightly purple. Lower on the wing, you'll see that it takes over a sort of green sheen. And that, again, is the light reflecting from the duvet, then passing through the wings, creating that green quality. While those wings change in their colour, hue, or nature, so does Webstrand's skin. Let's return to her face and her arms. You can see that at the moment, she has a very earthling colour, if you like. And there's a reason for this. At this moment, she doesn't want to alarm Fizz. She's very interested in communicating with her, so she doesn't want to look too alien, as it were. Webstrand has very chameleon-like skin. She can move from a dark blue through all the colours of the rainbow, in fact, so that she's very difficult to see against differing backgrounds. For most of her time, she wants to remain unnoticed. But as we move down across her legs, you will see that by the time that skin gets to her knees, it's quite green. And then it turns, by the time it's got to her feet, to a purpley red. So we've got the suggestion of that chameleon-like change across her body. In terms of the colours generally across this whole painting, you will see on the reveal that the first thing to do was to create the light, to create the contrasts between the darks and lights, not only between the background and the figure, but within the figure itself, to create the light on the gems and to create the contrast, for example, on her legs, so that we could see the light coming between those legs and really lighting up the spider's webs of her skirt. But the subtle colours are all created by glazing. Glazing, especially in the wings, gives all those subtle purples and greens and blues of which I was talking before. So the contrast in the wings is in the veins. The veins are dark against the light, but then the wings are full of light and full of colour because of the glazes which were applied gently and applied later. And you will see as you watch the reveal change from the initial drawing right through to the finishing touches, how those glazes change the whole image right up to the end, giving subtlety and scintillating colour to the painting as a whole. See how Webstrand appears on the pages of my originally written and illustrated book, especially designed by Sunita Gahir for Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. Catch some of the commissioned pieces of original music composed by Lisa Mulholland for the artist's first edition video storybook to depict Webstrand's first meeting with Fizz. Shown here from the first drawing out to the final finishing touches. We all live in a world of skepticism, disbelief, and doubt. But imagine, if you will, one filled with mystery and magic. Here, wishes can actually come true in a way you would hardly believe. Let me share with you the chronicle of an earthling who goes by the nickname Fizz, whose creative imagination and zest for life leads her on a remarkable journey. A journey which was to change her life forever, on which her guide was none other than Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. Watch as I depict the story of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. Through my scene setting, original Masterworks oil paintings. And the many storytelling illustrations that capture this epic tale. And listen as this chronicle of a wondrous journey is told. Well spotted, Fizz, Webstrand congratulated. Yes, it is an eye gem, but the flash doesn't develop until it's linked to its own special wearer. Owning an eye ring isn't just like wearing a piece of jewellery. It becomes the wearer's companion and can't be used by anyone else. And listen to the original musical soundtrack and soundscape that undulates through the good times and bad, the joy and horrors, the magical and real, the very essence of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. If, like Fizz, you also come to believe in Elphen and search carefully along a star's path, you may find what appears to be a small glowing ember in the undergrowth. But be on your guard, for once you start the search, it can soon become a quest. Welcome to my studio in the Highlands of Scotland, from where we bring you Paul Taggart's Elphen Chronicles. As a young child, I was a very solitary individual. I loved to play on my own, especially in my grandmother's garden. Part of the garden was cultivated, but the most of it was wild. And I loved walking through the long grasses and weeds and flowers that grew there. I remember those summer days, chasing butterflies and searching for insects and frogs under stones and logs. At the bottom of this garden, the very bottom of the garden, there was a small rise. And once I was beyond this small rise, I was hidden from my grandmother back in the house. Just at the bottom of the rise was a small area of different grasses. The large grasses diminished, and here was a swathe of fine green grass, and it grew in a perfect circle. And I remember one day, with the sun on my eyelids, as I sat on that rise, looking down on that grassy area, and just closing my eyes for a moment and reopening them, there was a movement, and I recognized it as a blue butterfly. Now, I know there are blue butterflies everywhere, but there weren't any in my grandmother's garden. I knew that because I'd chased many a butterfly. There were cabbage whites, there were tortoiseshells, red admirals, but I'd never seen a blue one there. So I was fascinated by it, but as I tried to focus my eyes on it, it disappeared. So I closed my eyes again and opened them just slightly, and the blue butterfly came back. And I thought this was incredibly strange. So I kept my eyes half closed, pretending I was asleep. And I watched this butterfly flutter around, and it was soon joined by another, and then another. And they began to fly in a circle, a clockwise circle around this green swathe of grass. Now, you may say, well, you're probably asleep. I had, after all, closed my eyes. But this was not the only occasion it happened. After that time, I went down to that spot again and again throughout the summer, and the blue butterflies came back. And soon, I became absolutely entranced by their magic. As an adult, I always wanted to capture the essence of this magic, which is how, in the mid-90s, I found myself bringing to life the mysterious creatures that are the Elphen. During the light of day, I would take up my brush and watercolour paints to work on a set of 18 unique illustrations that were enchanting me. As I painted, the story of Elphen began to develop in my mind. I became so engrossed that all other paintings and books were forsaken in order to free my imagination and allow me to concentrate on completing my first book in the Elphen Chronicles, in which I recount a particular legend involving the Elphen swarm leader Lacewing and an itinerant artist by the name of Artimus Glin. However, it had always been my hope to set aside enough time to work on a collection of oil paintings with which to depict another significant event in Elphen history. We invite you to join me as I share with you my latest illustrated book from Paul Taggart's Elphen Chronicles, Webstrand, the Tooth Gatherer. Fast forward a few years later, and once more the lure of the Elphen was too great to resist. I began work on another unique collection of masterworks oil paintings. 20 in all. Which were to take me well over 5 years to create. As before, the Elphen folklore of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer took over my life as I worked on these all-important masterworks. The composition for each Elphen portrait and scene-setting painting was originally based on my first draft of the narrative. Soon, however, I found myself changing the interpretation of the story within these paintings, as the world of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer took hold. Ultimately, the developing paintings had an ever-changing influence on the story, until both my paintings and story reached a natural conclusion. But this was merely the completion of the first stage. We were now about to embark on the next exciting phase, for the book had to be designed. We had a million ideas to explore. Why not some dedicated Elphen music? At the very least, the Elphen song, which comes into the story. Our wish list was growing as we added special items. The studio was filling with examples of uniquely produced work by talented craftspeople. What if we filmed the work in progress to share online, so that people could peek behind the scenes at the various creative processes? So, where are we now? Well, first off, the final and unique design for my lavishly illustrated book, Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer, has been completed by Sunita Gehia, our design director, for which I produced a further 116 vignette oil paintings. Quite different to my masterworks, these vignettes, scattered throughout the book, portray even more insight into the elfin folklore of Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer. And how about something else, which is a little bit different, something unique to us? A new concept, something that reflects the work we've been doing online for many years. An illustrated audiobook, maybe. What about something more than that? Welcome to our artist's first edition video storybook. All 9 chapters available now on Vimeo. We refer to this as the artist's first edition because the entire video storybook was created, filmed, and produced by us in our own studio here in the Highlands of Scotland. This unique concept of our video storybook was inspired by the artistic interpretations of my original story and paintings by our fellow collaborators. Both Sunita, in her captivating book design, and our music director, Lisa Mulholland, in her exclusive compositions, reflect the mood of the story as it unfolds from light beginnings through more challenging times, until ultimately reaching an enigmatic finale of hope and future possibilities. We invite you to listen along with me as I personally read my unabridged original story, accompanied not only by Lisa's evocative music, which wends its way through the entire 9 chapters, but also by my 20 masterworks. And the 116 vignettes, which are brought to life as I read from the pages of this video storybook. In the telling of the wondrous journey and epic tale that is the elfin folklore, Webstrand the Tooth Gatherer.